I honestly don't believe you need to break a bank in order to look stylish and being on point. I'm all about finding deals, bargains, mixing high-end designer with low-end and non-designers. That being said, today I'm sharing some of my designer dupe bags that only cost me less than $20. If you guys are interested to see what bags I'm talking about, don't forget to subscribe to my channel to see more of this kind of videos, and let's roll it and keep on watching. Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. It's your girl Parmzeh. By the way, before I start the video, if the lighting changes, I'm sorry. I'm doing my best to keep it very consistent, but I don't think it's gonna work out. We're having an overcast day and the lighting keep changing on me. As you know, I'm about to share with you all my good quality non-designer bags that cost me less than $20. I wanna start with Zara because Zara is a fast forward fashion company that mainly get inspired from designer products for a cheaper price. However, sometimes the quality can affect in this pricing, so you have to be very careful with what you're buying because end of the day, you just don't wanna toss your money. It doesn't matter if it's 20 bucks, $200 or $2,000. My point of making these type of fashion related videos are mainly to show you how to shop smart and also show you tips and tricks to make your shopping more enjoyable and easier. Okay, so as I said, I'm gonna start with Zara, stop rambling, and I will start with my bucket bags. Bucket bags are very, very trendy for the past 2 years or so. We love a good Chloe bucket bags, but it runs between $1,200 to $1,400, and this girl is not about to spend that much money unless they go on sale or she win a lottery. This is actually my very first bucket bag from Zara. I love the metal hardware on this bag. It's very easy to carry, inspired with the Chloe rings, and also it's very soft. The fabric, obviously it's not a real leather, but I don't mind it. I have this for over a year and I bought it for $7. Yes, you heard it right. I bought it from sale. I usually shop during the sale from Zara because to me, some of the products, as I said, they're not gonna last you a long time. So I'm not about to spend $70, $80 on some products. What great about this bag is you can run around, wear it as crossbody, and it also has a closure. So you can just tie it on top and your bag is closed. Let's be real, I never use it and it's always open. It's great when you're traveling, you don't wanna wear your designer bags. So if something happened to this bag, I'm not gonna trip about it. My next bag is also from Zara and it is a bucket bag again, super cute. The reason I bought this bag is because I can never keep anything ivory or cream white clean, and that's why I invested my $8 on this bag. And as you can see, I already made some areas dirty. I don't know if you can see it on camera, but there are some spots on it. So this girl is not about to spend $1,500 on a white bag and ruin it the next 10 minutes. This also comes with the longer strap. However, the strap is not as soft as the black one is, and the same closure comes with this bag, which I never use. But it's easier than the other bag because you can literally do this and it's closed. I barely use this strap on this bag. You can take it off or leave it on. I just kind of sometimes tuck it in the bag and I like carrying it from here. It just has a very clean and cool look to it. I like the hardware handle. It's super cool. We're stepping into spring and summer and we know all wooden, wicker basket bags are super, super trendy during summer and springtime since almost like a year and a half ago. That being said, I scored this basket wicker bag from Zara again last year during spring summer sale, and I bought this for $12.99. Definitely broke a bank. I love the color. Such a good neutral bag, and the shape, it's super cute. It doesn't have the typical handle, has this kind of rope, so I like kind of like carrying it on my elbow. The bottom has the faux leather, that way if it gets dirty, you can definitely wipe it off rather than being on the wicker side. Probably this is my most favorite Zara bag, and I can't wait for spring and summer to rock this again. You're gonna see it on my Instagram a lot this coming summer. My last Zara bag, I actually purchased it recently for $19 and on sale again. You know the drill. It's a transparent bag with a very cool belted details, has like a clasp closure, and it's magnetic. I'm currently wearing it to work every day. That's why you see stuff in there. You can wear it as a crossbody, has like a chain strap, or you can wear it from the top handle. If I'm going out to lunch or brunch, I usually wear it from the top handle, and when I'm going to work or running around, I'll just wear it as a crossbody. Also, it's just perfect for spring and summer, unless it gets melted under Texas sun. We'll see. I have one more transparent looking bag, and this is from actually Target. I wish I stuffed it because it's way cuter stuff. It's a cute backpack. I took this to Florida. Every time I went to the beach, I put just my sunscreen. I collected some seashells here. You can still see some of the sands right over here. I bought it for $12. I cannot wait to wear it again. Green, it's a big color this year, especially lime green. So I'm excited for this bag. The next three bags, they're gonna be from Urban Outfitters. I bought them again from sale. My first bag is actually from their vintage collection, which is more expensive, and these are genuine leather. It's a fanny pack, and the retail for this bag was around $350. I know, very expensive, because you can barely fit anything in this bag, and it has like a stone closure right over here. It barely fits anything, but I love this fanny pack, and I bought it for $20. I believe 3 or 4 years ago. I love wearing this fanny pack on my waist, style it as like a crossbody like this, and I don't really mind any of these scratches on this bag, because this type of leather meant to get scratched and look kind of like vintage. It's just such a great, cute fanny pack, which I cannot stop wearing for the past 3 years or so. And yeah, I get asked a lot about this bag on social media because it's just a picture perfect bag. In reality, it's really cute. It's tiny. It has like a python snake print. I bought this for $10 from Urban. I love the top handle. It actually comes with the longer strap. Let me see if it's inside. Here it is. I barely use this strap. It has like this sport type of strap, but I like wearing it from the top handle because it looks more expensive, especially in the pictures. It's super small, but I can definitely fit my wallet, my phone, lipstick, little mirror, my tampons in here, and that's enough for me. All right, my last bag from Urban, it's this oversized crossbody kind of fanny pack. I bought it for $9.99. I love the felt fabric. It's very wintry, fallish. It comes very handy when I'm traveling. It fits my Polaroid camera, my wallet, lipstick again, and it's just perfect. I love this. Speaking of winter fall bag, my next bag is my winter fall bag, and I bought it from the sister store of Urban Outfitter, which is Anthropology. I bought this on sale from Anthro for $20 last year. It's a full fur, super soft. It is a oversized clutch, which does have a chain strap. I love wearing this under my arm. Oversized clutches are gonna be super in 2019. If you see it and you know where you heard it first. Camera actually doesn't really capture the color, but this is not black. It's navy, army green, and this light powder bluish with ashy undertone. Every time I go to San Francisco, I take it with me. I love it. I get a lot of compliments, and you can even tell how much I bought it for. It looks expensive, but I paid only $20. Okay, my next bag, I actually didn't purchase it. It was gifted to me, and there is a company in Iran, in my country, that they specialized in leather goods. It's called Charm-e Mashhad, which you're not gonna probably understand what I just said. The name basically is one of the cities, one of the large cities in Iran, and Charm means leather. This is such a cutie. I love this triangle shape, Bottega inspired clutch. I love it. Again, it does come with the chain strap, but whenever I go to any parties, I barely wear the chain and I wear it as a clutch. I love the color. It's such a great burgundy. It's real leather, so it's super soft, and it looks like Bottega, but it's not. I don't know how much they paid for this. Probably, well, with the dollar value and everything is going on in the country, I'm pretty sure it costs less than $20 for us. My last bag, it's actually from Nordstrom. It's not a name brand bag, but it does look like Acris. I'm obsessed with this clutch. As you probably figured, I'm really into oversized clutches. Does have a good faux leather, which looks like a pebble leather, and it's super soft. I love how the shape is. Again, it comes with the chain strap. So my tip to you is try to go with the clutches that comes with chain strap. Sometimes the leather strap, because they are faux leather, they can be very stiff and hard. And sometimes they have that plastic looking, like a rubber look. That's why I stay with chains, just in case if I wanna wear them on my shoulder, I can wear the chain. But don't worry, if you find a bag, you really love it, and you have extra chain strap, you can definitely put it on and take off that plastic rubbery look strap. I bought this for $17 4 years ago. All right, guys, this is it. This was my affordable designer dupe bags that cost me less than $20. I hope you liked it. If you did, you know the drill. Please subscribe to my channel, like this video, share it with your friends, and I'll see you guys in my next video. Thanks so much for watching. Stay beautiful.